Thank you, Chris. Good evening. Welcome to the Deerfield Selectboard Public Meeting of October 19th, 2016, here in the Town Hall at 6:30 in the evening. We have scheduled John O'Rourke. He's not here, so we'll go on to other business. There is announcements. I guess the first thing I want to mention is that I just found out today that the Stillwater Bridge potentially could be closed, and we're working on that. It was inspected, and apparently the pier has been undermined so considerably that it isn't safe. So the Department of Transportation wanted to close it, and of course, over the years, we've had much discussion, and it is on, Trevor and I both verified this at a recent meeting, that it is on the 2021 to be repaired list by the state. In other words, the state's going to pay for it, even though it's our bridge. But being closed for 5 years is not it's a long time. So what we're working on, Kevin is very diligently pursuing, and we potentially have this worked out, that if we pay for the grout, the state will put sandbags under the pier, grout it in, and it will be a temporary fix that would be safe enough to have a restricted weight limit on it, but we could still get school buses and
cars
to go over.
Emergency vehicles.
We might not be able to get like a huge fire truck, but
what about farm tractor, you think? Probably
some farm vehicles, but not the really huge ones.
Right.
So it's we're working on that. And so as a result, if you notice when we get to the warrant, there is a potential article that is just, nothing's been done on it, but potential to take $50,000 from free cash to pay for the grout. The state would do it, so there's no permitting costs and all that kind of stuff. So, but we're negotiating that, and it's new information. So, of course, it's very serious because that's, you know, messes up school routes, that isolates that whole end of town.
Right.
And that's my neighborhood. So,
I know. Would you have to go into Greenfield, right?
Yeah, there's Greenfield. You go into Greenfield and then come down. Wow. So, I mean, it adds 3 or 4 miles on top of, you know, already trying to get down here. So I hope we can work this out. So needless
Kevin's
to say, and obviously one of the biggest things to do is if that works out, if we get this temporary fix, then the next thing that we'd be working on, which we're going to do right now, is start. So we're going to have to start sending letters, and when we go to meetings, start every time we see somebody or talk to somebody, we got to like complain and whine and say, oh man, this is like a huge thing for us. And because the tip, you know, the how they allocate transportation bond money is you know, every year. And the reason why we were getting bumped is because we were sort of like, it was deficient bridge for quite a while, and there was always bridges coming on that were worse case.
So now we are one of the worst case.
So we should be able to get bumped up.
It takes time
to advertise. It takes time to go out to bid.
Engineering
and all that kind of stuff. So, I mean, we're only going to shave off.
The state is going to do that. We wouldn't have to do anything.
No, that was why I've been such. I mean, this has been my whole thing for like 10 years. That's all I've been doing. Having to go all these meetings. I was a representative, a South County rep on the Transportation Committee for years. And I would only go just so I could get that bridge on. And because it's a multi-million dollar cost to us, and it's our bridge.
And it's so vital.
So either that was how, you know, we got on the list, is because, you know, I just kept saying it was an emergency. You can't, you know, it's needful for emergency. It's not, we can't afford it. And anyway, I always had stories.
Sure.
And
it's time to.
So, but it, it's been a, you know, for years, it's been an off and on thing, and so we've, you know, we made that, we got that commitment for the 21, and so I think we could shave off a year or two. I think a year or two is probably going to be the most optimistic.
Right.
So,
right.
So if we can get a temporary fix and have a reduced weight load, that will be okay, because it won't disrupt the, you know, school
right.
routes and stuff like that. And you'll be able to still and get ambulance.
That's what I mean. Yeah, if you've got to get South County EMS has got to get up there.
I mean, I know.
All the way up 5 and 10 and all the way back.
I know. It would be awful. Anyway, that was like just this afternoon at 3:30.
Oh. Is that when they inspected it?
No, but
that's
I found
when they
out
called.
About it, Kevin.
Yeah.
When I came in and Kevin told me about it, and it just happened that that he just found out about it.
They sent divers down recently, right?
That was the result. Of, mm-hmm. Originally, what happened is, and Irene, as I said before, the scouring, there was always scouring, and that was why it was we needed to get it fixed. But when Irene happened, the scouring got filled in. But then new scouring happened, and I think this is new scouring.
Probably undermined the whole thing.
Yeah, it's undermined, and I think the repair work from 91 with those very heavy trucks, just, you know, the bouncing and stuff, I think that's what caused it. I don't know.
When the going back and forth and back and forth over it?
Yeah.
We should have put a sign up there and not let them cross it until they fix that one.
I know. I mean, what are you going to do? So, anyway, but
okay.
We're going to pursue it. I just, you know,
it may be an article.
It may be an article, and I just wanted you to know that we're
okay.
Trying to be on top of it and send out letters, whatever. Okay. And John is here now.
Hey,
so, John, hey,
welcome.
Come on up.
Welcome.
We have.
Are you guys meeting right now?
Yes, we're on tape.
Where is that?
Well, the Triad Spaghetti Dinner.
Yeah, I think it's
the Polish Club.
We're competing.
We've been upstaged.
With, yeah. Good. We've been.
Trevor. How are you? Welcome.
John.
How's it going?
Good. Good.
Thank you for coming tonight. This is a very complicated discussion about electricity, so I really appreciate you coming. Because we hear that our deal that we had with the HCOG was probably not the best anymore. So I will turn it over to you.
That's probably true. Now, you're talking about your municipal accounts, correct? Okay. Basically, we have a very large clientele of commercial, municipal, and industrial accounts, as well as being the leader in Massachusetts in municipal aggregation or community aggregation. All I would need from you is to get a quote on your accounts, is a letter of authorization, and which I have with me, and a copy of all the bills for the accounts that you want quoted.
I guess I should, you know, just for people that don't know, John is, we all know John from as a Conway Select Board person. So that's why we're talking to you in such a familiar manner. I sometimes people watch and they don't understand totally.
Right.
So
right.
We're on multiple committees. We go to multiple meetings together. Yep. So we feel very comfortable with you, John. And as you know, we have no staff at the moment here in Deerfield. So I can
town administrator?
Yes, mm-hmm. And executive assistant. So yeah. I will get the electrical bills from Brenda and try to get them to you. If you can give me a card on your way out.
She can just email them to me.
Yeah, and then we can. So you need the bills of all the accounts that we want. And that, so that would essentially be everything. Isn't we have the elementary school, right? Or with the elementary school, that's part of their budget.
I think it is.
But we would want them to be quoted, right?
Why not?
Wendy, don't you think we would want them quoted, get a quote for the elementary school?
What's under the current and get, you know, whatever's covered by the current cost program. Mm-hmm. We'll get that.
And so if I ask Brenda to forward it to him, that would probably be the appropriate person?
Yeah, we'll talk about that.
Okay. All right. So we'll get Brenda and Pat to do that.
Okay.
Forward all the bills, including the elementary school, because obviously if you can do a good deal for us as municipal, we would want to have the elementary school included.
That, yeah, that's fine. That's fine.
So, okay. We should probably let Lynn know in case she wants to do Frontier.
I'll reach out to her.
Yeah, unfortunately, the council seems to be imploding right now in terms of their electricity program. So.
So John, why don't you just give us your spiel? Because, you know, quite honestly, I am very confused, and I'm always nervous about making long-term commitments because I think I'm not.
Okay. Well, essentially, what we would do for you is just quote, get a quote for you, and then the quote would be, normally we get a range of quotes from at least three, if not five, potential suppliers. That'll give you a quote for 12, 18, 24 months, and longer if you want. And then you look at the quotes, and if you like one, you pick it out. If you don't like it, we could wait and re-quote it some other time. It's, you know, it's that simple.
Now, we have to make a decision in November, so would we
You're November 1? Are you a November 1?
I think
November
it is.
1?
It's either November 1 or the 30th, right?
No, it's the first.
It's the first.
I'm 90% sure.
Yeah,
first.
I think you're right. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Michelle, how are you?
Yeah, we can get a quote for you within 2 or 3 days of receiving the bills.
Well, we are actually meeting weekly, so we will have a meeting next week.
Okay.
And we can make a decision based on that. Do
sure.
you feel?
Yeah. As long as you can get those bills, so you can get to work on it.
Could you get Kip's email and
he
then
has it.
I
you
have
can.
It.
Send it to all of us, but I want to make sure that Kip is the one that reviews it and make a recommendation to us for us
sure.
next week. Okay, because you were going to call back Barry too, right?
Yes.
Okay. That sounds wonderful, John.
Okay. All right.
Is there anything else you need to tell us, or
he has a letter? Did you have?
You know, the municipal accounts. Quoting the municipal accounts is a relatively simple process. It's just a matter of looking at the bills you have, looking at the load shape, and putting it out to responsible bidders. And then again, we will make a recommendation. You will see everything that we have gotten in quotes. We'll make a recommendation to you, and you can accept it or reject it, depending upon what.
So do you have the correct letter of authority?
Yes.
Okay. So you're all set.
Yeah,
and we can forward the electric bills to you.
Yes.
I'll make sure that
you want us to sign that.
What you can do is you can look this over,
And
you can email a copy of this to me that's signed.
No, we can sign it right now.
Okay.
I will make a motion that we sign this.
Thank you very much.
I'll second it.
Is there any further discussion?
And Kip, you're going to be the contact on that?
Sure.
No, I don't think so.
Do you have any further discussion?
No, I'm good.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Okay. I have to take minutes.
Yes.
So,
yes, I was supposed to remind you.
So.
3-0.
Do you want us to sign this and you want to take it, John?
That'll be fine.
Okay. Why don't you sign it?
And then
he can fill.
I'll fill in the account number.
Okay. So it's just one signature. So.
Yeah. You can do it.
Okay.
Great. And again, this is a very straightforward process.
Okay.
You know, you'll see everything that we've gotten in terms of quotes, and then you can make a decision on it.
There you go, John.
Thanks, Carol. And I'll send you a copy of this as well.
Okay.
Okay.
And I'll put Kip's name in as the contact.
Sure. Yes, please.
Sure. Great.
Trevor.
Thank you.
Seeing you.
Very good to see
John,
you, too.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Kip, good seeing you.
And I will make a note that, and take your card so that you get this information tomorrow.
That's great.
I hope tomorrow.
And again, I'll get it into our quoting department, and early next week, we'll have a quote for you.
Okay, perfect.
Great.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, John.
Thank you, John, very much.
I guess I wasn't too tired.
Have a good night.
You too.
Thank you.
How are you?
Oh, so I made the motion.
Yep. Kip seconded. And I'll reach out to Lynn, and should I check with Patty about the, will you have the bill here for the electricity at the school?
I'm pretty sure because we would pay, even if it's from their budget,
we pay
through the warrant.
Okay.
So I'm pretty sure that Wendy would have the elementary school, but...
She may want to get in on the...
Lynn might want Frontier to get in on, you just pass the information on.
Sure.
So that, I mean, somebody would have to authorize it, obviously.
Right.
The whole thing, but...
Okay. I'll reach out to...
If it's significant, which is supposed to be some savings, right?
We'll see.
My understanding is there's quite a bit of savings potential.
I'm not sure how, you know, I really don't know how much there is. I do know that the rate that we have now was okay, but it wasn't going to stay the same anyways.
And that system that we're in right now is just kind of not working out right now for them, or?
No, I think they've got internal problems, and it's going to implode.
Is it a group of people together?
Oh, no, no. It's a quasi-county. It's the Hampshire Council of Governments.
Okay.
And they have an electricity department. Well, I'm not sure. I think it's been 2 years ago they applied to the Department of Public Utilities to do this aggregation and stuff to go further, and they got turned down, and the reason they got turned down is because the Department of Public Utilities does a lot of investigation. First, they found out that they really weren't saving their clients' money.
Second of all, as proposed.
A lot of the internal auditing, they had problems with it, and they had some management problems, and it's just been getting worse and worse and worse.
Okay.
I mean, in that department, in 4 years, they've gone through 28 people, to give you an idea, and it's pretty much almost done. So I didn't want to get us to get caught up in that.
Right, be stuck in there with a contract.
Because then, who know? I don't know how it would be dealt with after the fact. So
right,
now's a good time to go move on.
Like Montague's moved on. I mean, they handled a lot of towns here, and they handled a lot of towns in Hampshire County, and I don't know what the total number of towns were, but there was quite a few.
Yeah. But in big towns, they did some, in East part too. But, they're just a reseller, kind of like a joint.
Yep.
But the towns have been dropping out. Bigger towns get billed wrong. I don't know how well we scrutinize our bills, but a lot of people have really been calling there, complaining because their bills are way off, and they don't seem to get addressed, and it's been a lot of problems.
Well, like us, we don't have a very complicated.
We're simple.
Whereas towns like Revere, they have multiple
And
things.
Obviously, Brenda's going to know, but I believe that when I look through it, we only have two contracts with them. A lot of stuff is lumped together.
Right.
But, I'm sure Brenda will know more than I do. But
yeah. Okay. Sounds good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
But it's really good because we've been talking about this for a couple of years.
Have you?
Yeah. So I'm...
It's a great timing, man.
Yeah. So thank you for...
Yeah. And I think, getting back to your question as far as the savings goes, it's going to be a little... I'm not going to know until we see from John seems what it is,
But it's more stable. Maybe it's a more stable environment.
Oh, it's definitely more stable. Yeah. But there was also, Montague saved some money.
Saved some money.
Yep.
Yeah, they saved pretty good money.
Yep.
They are bigger users than us, but they have more. But I don't know. We'll see. Anyway, back to announcements. Our rec department this weekend has spooktacular. There's 6 p.m. at the elementary school. There's bubbling potions, haunted graveyard effects, melting witch heads, a whole bunch of stuff. So it sounds like thrilling look into the secret world of the Mad Scientist Laboratory. So
that'll be fun.
6 p.m. at the elementary school. And now this is dodgeball camp. Register now. It's Thursdays, November 10th and 17th, December 1st and 8th. This is, again, at the elementary school, 6 to 7, and it's for kids ages 7 to 12. So it's all this information is at the rec department's website.
That's really a fun. Caleb couldn't get in last year. It was so packed. So come early and sign up.
Yeah, oh, good. We also have one other announcement. The 3.2K walk for your veteran, it's November 6th. It's sponsored by the Veterans Foreign Wars Post 3295. And it's at the Senior Center, noon, at the Senior Center. And you can sign up at 11:30.
Yeah.
And you can display your veteran's name, rank, and branch of services. Families are encouraged to attend, and it's a walk around South Deerfield. That I'm pretty sure. Let me make sure that gets up on the web page. If it isn't,
can I break in for a second?
Sure.
I should have mentioned before that I will talk to John about the solar credits that we're probably going to be getting from the River Road operation.
Okay.
And you know, see how that fits in. I don't know how soon they're going to be up and running, but, you know, I know that we're...
They're working on it.
We are. I think we were offered a 25% reduction in whatever credits we get from there. So that, you know, if I don't know how it works, if it's 25% off of what they're going to charge us or what we get for prices or how it works. But in any event, it'll save us some money.
Thank you.
Right.
We have minutes from October 5th and October 12th. I did thin them up with Pat. They are not great as they normally are.
We should have Bruce Hunter come do it.
I know. He's very good.
I know. So I just, and I'm sorry you haven't had a chance to read them, but it shouldn't take you very long.
Yep, I did. I'm good.
Oh,
yep.
Okay.
Yep, I'm good.
Oh, you are?
Yep.
Okay. Oh, thank you. Well, I will take a motion to approve the minutes of the 5th and the 12th.
I make a motion that we accept the minutes of the 5th and the 12th.
Second.
Okay. Is there any further discussion?
No.
Okay. Hearing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. We have to sign the warrant. And now we were supposed to open and close the warrant tonight, but I'm putting it on next week's agenda because it's still not done.
Sure.
But did you have any opportunity to look at it? Is there anything you wanted to tell Wendy about?
I just saw it tonight, so
okay.
I did not.
So take it home.
I will.
And look at it and see if there's anything you want to add. I know Wendy forwarded it out to the Finance Committee because I was worried that the Finance Committee hasn't had a chance to look at anything.
Mm-hmm.
And Dan Graves, our moderator, hasn't had a chance to look at anything.
Yeah.
And the Capital Improvement Committee hasn't looked at anything. I sent that out, actually, to John. I shouldn't say it. They hadn't had a chance to look at it, but the motions aren't included. So if we open and close it next week, which we have to if we're going to post it properly,
correct,
we're going to have to work on the motions in a relatively short order so that I can run it by the Capital Improvement, because the Capital Improvement articles are the ones, you know, it's going to be made
for those
by
bylaws.
Yeah,
yep.
For the bylaw changes. So
okay.
But I'll work on that with Wendy. If you guys make sure that you get back to her.
Okay.
If there's anything you want to do.
Well, we're good with the Frontier one. That language is
yes,
all set.
Yes, the Frontier
so
one
fine.
Is correct.
Okay.
And Wendy is forwarding it around to the other towns so that they have the wording.
Mm-hmm.
So everyone is going to vote on the same thing.
Okay.
And the council has okayed that format, and it does what we want it to do on the housing.
Great.
So it should be okay. But again, that's, I mean, it's just repurposing money, but the Finance mm-hmm. Committee should look at it
sure.
anyway, even yep. though it's not
it was
new
approved
money.
Before,
yes,
right. okay.
approved before, yep. but they should just give a recommendation
sure.
to approve anyway, just for what we should do. Next item on the agenda is the SCEMS housing. You had given us the
a lease agreement that I
worked out. Lease agreement. I guess the only thing I really wanted to discuss was just, you know, you get concerned that you have a kind of good deal, say this $36,000. People say, well, what if in 5 years we want to up it? My thing was just to say it was just going to be renewable until, you know, it's not agreed upon anymore.
I mean, as far as the dollar-wise goes, I don't have a problem with that. I just have a problem with having a lease that doesn't have an end date.
Yeah.
So if you want to extend it out, even if you want to go 15 years or something like that, 3-year increments, because I think you had told me that selectmen can only sign 3 years at a time anyways.
Yep.
So if we say can be renewed up to 5 times, and, you know.
Okay. I mean, does that... I mean, we can bring it up at the BOO tomorrow.
Yeah, we can talk about it.
And say that we're okay. Let's for us now, say that we're okay for the, up, you know, around 15 years. But,
sure. We can say
but we can have more discussion at the BOO.
Sure.
I just want to assure the other two towns that, you know, at,
the price will stay the same.
Yes. Our purpose is to offer a stable.
Unless we all decide as a community to add on or something.
Right. Yeah,
right. Improve the building somehow.
Right.
I mean, if we have to expand,
and there is some language in here that talks about expansion, but that was existing language. Like mm-hmm. like I said, the cover page that's just a summary, and the premises, Article 1 and 2, are the only things that I changed. Everything else is exactly as
then. Was. Then what we need to do is I need to get Pat. You have a clean copy. Can I already
yeah,
wrote
sure
it?
Yeah, sure you
I'm
can.
Sorry.
Yep. No, that's fine.
I'll just have Pat make copies, and I'll pick them up tomorrow to take to the meeting.
Okay.
Because we should mm-hmm. have copies for the
sure. For everybody.
For yep. the committee. How many copies do we should make? Like 10?
So,
10. And Mike, six. I've gotten a plan.
I mean,
so
I got mine.
So if you make six or so.
Provide just for my education. Provided. You know, the Board of Oversight decides hypothetically. And
Wendy, please have a seat if you want.
In your car.
I just wanted to let you know something.
Okay. So my thought was, go ahead. I'll.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Don't lose your thought.
I won't. I'll hang on the way.
I know we're talking about the cable contract signed,
yes.
and I just found an email where the attorney was trying to set up a joint meeting of all the towns, and I didn't think that was, I wrote back saying I'm not sure if the other administrators agree, but I think that might be more difficult to set up than him coming. So I let him know that you're meeting weekly and you usually have early meetings. Is that accurate, that it would probably work best for
yeah.
him to just come here rather than try to set up yet another?
He's been on our agenda several times. He was
okay.
supposed to come, so.
I said that was probably your preference. And
yeah. Well,
it was going to be hard to schedule all the boards together, and the people in the town, I think, should be able to come to their own town, you know,
I was
hear about the contract. And,
yeah, I mean, I'm kind of uncomfortable getting us all together for just something that is already agreed upon, sort of.
Right.
I mean, it's kind of a waste
okay,
of time.
Okay, so I anticipated that, and I read
you
that
did.
Back. Okay.
Perfect.
I would rather have us have something that we can have discussion rather than just show up, have all of us go out in the evening just to sign a contract. I mean, because it's all agreed upon already.
Yep.
I mean, it's pretty much done.
Mm-hmm. It's done.
Yeah. So
well, pending your
they
approval.
Just want us to sign it, and I mean, it makes no sense. Everyone agrees that that's probably the best we can do, and he's the best guy in the state. So why wouldn't we sign it?
Come on down.
I know. So you
Thank
know, it's
you.
Kind of
that was
a,
with Comcast, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
now, when you said the
no,
best guy, I mean...
No, Bill is Solomon is the best attorney, supposedly.
Oh, okay. So he's our attorney or Comcast?
Yours. No, he's our attorney
hired. He's representing the town.
All four towns.
I see.
And he's negotiated this contract, and...
Okay.
I mean, realistically...
I'm not going to second-guess him.
Yeah, no, it's not worth it, and it's important to sign it because technology's changing, and so we might actually end up... If we don't sign it, we might end up with no money.
I don't know the details, but you get money.
To pay for FCAT.
FCAT gets money.
Yeah.
So...
Yeah.
I will pull those out if you don't have them. Okay.
Thank you. Doug was very knowledgeable, and he said the contract was good to go and that it was the best that we could do, and he had been involved in the whole thing the entire time. Mm-hmm. So I don't want people to think that we're just, okay, just sign it.
No, you had an expert person working.
Yes, and he worked with Bill, and they negotiated the best we could do based on future technology.
Right.
So I think we got actually a good deal.
Yep.
Yeah.
And that's why we want to sign it quick.
Right, get that money flowing.
Before Netflix or somebody else gets going.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
Thank you, Wendy.
Thanks.
If there's anything, Wendy, I can stop in tomorrow afternoon. And okay, so we'll connect tomorrow afternoon. Okay.
Thank you.
Trevor Slott.
Yes, back to my question. So providing all the stars align and we end up, you know, Board of Oversight would like to move forward this plan. We have a building put up, and it's 15 years down the road, and we want to do something to the building. I assume Deerfield is the owner of that building. Would the Board of Oversight kind of make a request to add on, and then it would be up to us as owners to kind of expand and then adjust the lease and all that
I
kind
think
of stuff?
Yes.
Probably.
Just wondering how the logistics of all that goes.
Probably.
Okay.
There is a strong, you know, way of doing this where a tenant makes leasehold improvements and stuff like that. But a lot of times that's offset with different things with rent and stuff. And I think it's just cleaner to do it this way.
Right.
We can keep control of the quality of the construction, the look of the facility, and make sure everything's the same. If you let a tenant make leasehold improvements and that, well, this was cheaper, I didn't know you wanted to do it, you know, it can get to a lot of gray areas. And then, you know, as a landlord, we assume that what they did was proper, and that if there's a problem that going down the road, then we have to, you know, assume that.
So we'll do it ourselves.
I mean,
do it.
I think it is
yeah. Okay.
Easier.
I was just curious how that went about. If they wanted something done, it would need to be kind of
they can
requested.
Request. Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, and okay. So depending on what happens tomorrow night at the meeting, if people want to go forward with this, then we are going to have to meet with the Capital Improvement Committee and the Finance Committee between now and the 14th. I mean, the Finance Committee can, and I'm pretty sure the Improvement Committee, too, by bylaws, can make the recommendation on the 14th as well. But
at that meeting.
Yeah, but it behooves us to have public discussion and have a couple multiple meetings.
Sure.
Yes. We can have a meeting. I mean, since we're meeting weekly, we don't have to have another whole separate night, but we should bring it up and have public discussion.
Yes. Yep. Bring in the public.
Yeah. I mean, just so people can understand what we're doing and that it truly is a wash for us as a town, especially if we have donations and stuff.
Do you think that the importance that we should mention this special town meeting on November 14th several times throughout our meetings just so people watch
it? Well,
kind of, you know, they don't watch the whole thing, but they might catch this. And
yes.
Because, you know, getting the word out to people is always problematic.
They will be having a special town meeting.
And based, our hope is to do the open and closing of the warrant next week. And that we will have the special town meeting on November 14th at 7 p.m. here in the town hall.
So tell all your friends and neighbors to come.
Yes. It's our hope that we will be on time. Now, we could postpone it and have to shift it again if we're not ready, but our hope is to have a November 14th special town meeting.
Yep.
Okay. The personnel board was unable to meet last night because they did not have a quorum. Someone was sick, so we need to sort out. We don't have a recommendation.
So we'll just put that off till next month?
Yes, for Greg.
Okay.
I mean, Sachs. pay, but I'm hoping that we will, can schedule a meeting because Zach is hiring a new, a new person that has to be reviewed.
Okay.
As starting not at the first step. So, you know, okay. Similar to the other.
Town clerk.
The other EMS people.
Oh.
It's not competitive at EMS grade 3, step 1. It has to be step 3 or 4. And that's what has been approved in the past, but that has to be revisited as well. And I actually should put that in there so I don't forget that it's EMS grade 3, and it should be step 3 or 4, depending on the applicant, is what has been approved in the past. And it's been established that it's not competitive at step 1. Because this was established back in 2009, so. Mm-hmm.
Has there been any progress? Because I totally don't understand the process with this compensation adjustment that we're doing.
I really don't know where that's at. I mean, I wish.
So we're in the same boat.
Yeah.
So we just, who's doing it?
Wendy is, I just spoke to her this afternoon about it. I said, how are we doing on this? And she is trying to sort this out.
Okay. But the person that we hired, he's completed his work and gave us that report. And we have to work to try and get it. Okay.
Yeah.
Is there anything that
she what is happening? We had indicated that we were interested in a human resource, shared human resource person, and the FERCOG was getting us technical help for that, so that we would share that person with, it's a technical grant through the state, so this shared person would help us with some of these issues. So I know Wendy called because I was there. We were just talking about this being not competitive, and we need to address this. So she was talking to the person at the FERCOG to see where we were at with the technical help, where we got left off, and if we could pick it up to finish it. Not much has been done for a year yet. That's okay. The problem.
On that same note, does FERCOG have anyone that we could reach out to as far as like a temporary town administrator or office type help? They don't offer that kind of services?
Okay. No. And actually, now that Wendy's back, it's a lot better. I mean, she's doing these things, believe it or not.
I don't dispute it. I don't see any difference. It's the only thing I know is if I need something, I can't. A few times I've gone in to see Pat, and she didn't understand. So,
if you need to get something done, because we're obviously we can't have any deliberation, we can't talk to each other. So, if you need something done, make a note, leave it with Pat. Mm-hmm. Pat will forward it to Wendy.
Yeah,
and Wendy and I will work on it.
Okay,
and because it's going through Pat to Wendy, I'm coming in all the time. To check. And by the way, I appreciate, because my mom was in the hospital, that you signed the paychecks, because I didn't get in here before noon.
Yep.
And Trevor and I had that meeting in Amherst, so I didn't have time to stop and sign the paychecks. So thanks for doing that.
No problem.
But Wendy's coming in two or three times a week to do follow-up on these things like the warrant, making sure that it gets the lawyer and back and all that kind of stuff. So you just need to let Pat know, and then that's not considered deliberation because Wendy and Pat, and even though there is nobody doing regular stuff, I'm trying to handle the regular stuff as much as possible. So,
okay. Well, then you're doing a good job.
Thank you very much. But
I haven't seen anything, but that's okay.
I am waiting to get somebody on board here because this is not great.
Working on that.
Yeah. Yes. We'll have you have a report in a minute. The next item on the agenda is the Ad Hoc Town Common Committee. wonderfully, Trevor has been going, so I'd like to make a motion to create an ad hoc town common committee to work on the plantings and also other issues on the town common that are being addressed right now. And it's Mary Andrianopoulos, if I'm chopped up her name, I'm really sorry. Darren Gray, Diane Gripko, Trevor, of course, and Jane Chergere as chair. John Siz from the Memorial Day Committee, and Colleen Dugas from as a member of the Open Space Committee.
Yes, we had just a little bit on that. We had one meeting, and we're reaching out to Conway School of Design, Architectural Design. They're doing a project to kind of come together with some ideas on how we can make improvements and safer walking, kind of updating, see what we can do to freshen up that area. So we should have a report back. I want to say it's in November or December. So,
well, it probably would be. It would be based on the term. You know, the kids' semester.
How their semester is. Yeah.
So it would be the end of the semester.
Jane, so I know, is working on getting that going. So.
You might, for the beginning of December.
Yeah. Okay.
Probably. Because they'd have to do a presentation.
Correct.
And all that kind of stuff.
And
we'll, so
we'll bring all that to the public. And
perfect.
See what we can do to improve things there.
Would you second that?
I'll second it.
Is there any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay. Messed up here. Okay. Public record access officer's appointment. This is under the new modernization bill. Barbara is going to work on the policy, but the policy doesn't need to be, it's going to be based on the state's. I had gotten some clarification because, you know, this was on the agenda not too long ago. So we can appoint the public records access officers. And we will appoint not the persons, but we, which is kind of listed here, but we appoint the positions. So we would appoint, I make a motion to appoint the town clerk and the police clerk. And the reason we would are going to go ahead and appoint them is because when people come in, it's worked out fine, actually. We actually have no issues because Barbara handles most everything. And then the people that have want a traffic accident report or arrest,
the police clerk can do
they
that.
Just go into the police clerk. But by appointing the position, it is official, and then we'll work on the policy. It does say to have the policy first, but the state isn't even going to have the policy until January. Then Barbara's going to work with us to come up with a policy based on what the state comes up with, and then we have to have it by law by July 1st.
Okay.
So
couldn't we just adopt the state's policy? Because anything we do, if it contradicts it, it would just be a...
Well, you can make it a little bit stricter, apparently, according to Barbara, but not... I mean, you can change some stuff, and that's why everybody's waiting until the state comes out in January. But just to clarify, so there's no issues, the police clerk will handle the police issues, the town clerk will handle...
Any town.
Everything else. So I make that motion.
Second.
Okay. All those in favor?
Aye.
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 Okay. So we're appointing the position. That was just a clarification because, and Barbara doesn't even want to address it till after
the state gets there.
Till or after elections, she doesn't even want to start the process. But
it
doesn't make any sense to have us spend any time in the policy until we see what the state does anyway.
Sure.
So she's going to spearhead that. The hotel for the MMA conference was supposedly booked for you and I, Trevor, but I left at noontime and I didn't see a
confirmation.
So I'll follow up on that. I will follow up on that. Supposedly that was done.
And is that for Friday night only, right?
No, it's Thursday, Friday, and Saturday night.
Oh, okay, I thought it was just the two.
Because it starts on, in the morning on, early in the morning on Friday.
Okay, so you need to be out there already?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we usually go Thursday night, Friday night, and Saturday nights through the stuff.
Okay.
I didn't sign you up, or we don't normally sign up for any of the dinners because they're so overpriced.
Sure, we can always get something.
Yeah, and we normally go out with, I mean, that's the whole idea is to go with other towns.
Mingle with people and learn from people. Yeah, absolutely.
And I signed you up as a new person, so you get the extra, you know, they give you little extra books and stuff.
Great.
And I hope you can decide to come, but it doesn't matter.
I'll just call and make whatever arrangements and stuff.
Okay. Next item on the agenda is it's come up in the discussion for the sewer, that the sewer interest rates, you know, now that we're making more money, it never was very substantial amount of money in the reserves, but now that we are actually having substantial charges, we're going to be generating money in the reserve. And so we need, when I talked to Brenda about this, we need to take vote to, there has to be a specific vote that the sewer reserve fund monies go back, interest goes back to the sewer reserve.
Well, I would think that it would, should have always been that way. But the way I'm thinking is if you have a sewer reserve fund and it generates some interest, what did they take that interest out of that account and then put it into general fund?
No, if it generated interest, it just went into the general fund. And it was not a big deal because the town has always subsidized stuff. But we're now, you know, we're charging the sewer rate, sewer reserve for any repair work, time for people to do stuff. And this just makes sense when it came up that we do it. But when I talked to Brenda, it has to be actually an official vote by the select board. So
okay. I make a motion to have the interest from the sewer reserve fund. I'm sorry, does it go back into the interest on the sewer
go to the sewer reserve fund and not the general fund, I guess, just to clarify it.
I'll second it.
Is there any further discussion?
No.
Aye.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Sorry. I'm still writing. Kip, second. I'm sorry. This is not even funny. I'm really slow.
That's good.
I'm just
getting it down.
I know. Okay. And we have to sign the new police contract because the calculations are corrected. Now, the only other thing that I had on the agenda was, I don't know if you saw that note from Barbara. She was just worried.
I think that.
So I was just thinking we could take one of our selectmen's nights and just say we would make it a sewer information night.
Well, we could do both, couldn't we?
Yes.
But yeah, definitely.
Yeah, set an agenda item on next week or something.
One thing I wanted to add to that.
Or the first week in November, maybe.
It was mentioned that maybe we should several times during our meetings over the next few weeks to actually read the letter that goes out. Just because some people catch it on TV, some people don't. I know they'll get a thing in the mail, but at least we could, you know, tell people enough several times that, you know, I'd be happy to read the statement, but whatever we put in the sewer bill for an explanation of why the rate has changed and what we're looking to do and what needs to happen, and maybe we can get some input from the Sewer Study Commission to, you know, just why all this is taking place now. So I'd be happy to read that, you know,
every couple of times. I spoke with Brenda about this last week, and I told her that I would work with Michelle and develop a letter. But then I got an email from her saying that her and the other girl had developed something, so I just kind of backed down from it.
Would you be willing to
edit it or something?
Yeah, just review it and edit it if necessary it through your sewer. When's the next sewer meeting?
I don't know unless I look.
Do you know, Jeff?
our next meeting?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can talk. The 15th, November 15th.
That's right.
Is there a committee meeting?
Yeah, we're going to have to do it before that.
Yeah, well, I was going to put it on the agenda for November 2nd. I mean, we can, next week we can read about, but, well, would you feel comfortable then as just editing it?
I'll look at it, sure.
You could run it by people, but.
Oh, yeah. No, that's no problem.
And then I think it is a good idea that we talk about it every meeting.
Yeah, right.
But how about 6:45 on the 2nd, we'll put it on.
And I had made a request to Pat, and I don't know if she forwarded it on to you all, that I was wondering if we could make that the 1st?
Oh. I thought it was November 30th and the 29th. You wanted the 29th?
I had to change the number to 30th.
And I already told her it was okay.
Oh, that was something different. Okay.
So
that, yes, that was right. I did need to move the 30th, and maybe I didn't mention this, or I could certainly miss a meeting too.
No.
We're talking November. Did you say November 2nd? Right.
Yeah.
I think that's when I'm going to the.
Okay. So.
So here's November 2nd. I'm leaving to go to school committee conference at the Cape.
Okay.
But I could do the 1st if anyone's available on the 1st that week.
Is that okay, the 1st for you?
Yes.
Okay. So what I'm going to do is we'll have the sewer night on November 1st at 6:30.
Okay.
And I will tell Pat to post selectmen's meeting on the 1st.
Still at 6:30 though.
On the 1st of November at 6:30.
Yep, so it'll be sewer night and.
Sewer night and a new posting.
So that's Tuesday.
Yeah.
Tuesday.
Is that okay?
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
And we're also changing, Kip, from the 30th of November to the 29th of November.
Oh, okay.
And I already told Pat that was fine, if as long as it worked out with Kip's schedule.
The 30th of November?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've just got to work.
29th. Okay.
Thing that night.
Is that going to be at 6:30?
Yes.
Yes.
So.
Thank you.
We have two November meetings that will be on Tuesday. And since we don't have, I mean, I'm sure, even if we have a town administrator, we're going to meet every week through November. And I would hope that, I hope. Do you have an update?
The 1st and the 29th will be.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep, on Tuesdays.
And then it'll be the two middle Wednesdays.
Wednesdays.
Although, we are not meeting the night before Thanksgiving. We are skipping that week.
All right.
All right? Is that okay?
That's the 23rd, right? Yep. No meeting. Of November.
Yeah. I'm not.
Unless somebody's bringing turkey.
I have to cook.
My family comes up and.
Okay.
You know,
what am I going to do then?
You're welcome to come for dinner.
I have dinner for 20, and I'm not.
For 20?
Yeah.
Holy.
Well, we're going to your house for dinner then.
You know, I'm cooking, so. Unfortunately, my mom has given it up a few years now, so I have to do this.
Yeah,
so.
That's fine. That's what it's all about.
No, I'm not coming here.
It's family and.
Yeah,
it's
it
great.
Is. Oh,
it's
no,
great.
I have no problem.
Sure.
It's just that I'm not coming to a selectmen's meeting the night before Thanksgiving. Okay. So we will meet three times in November. Oh, no, actually, I think there's 5 weeks, isn't there?
Yeah, three. We'll meet four times.
Yes, we're still meeting four times. It's just that week of Thanksgiving. So we're meeting, to be clear, we're meeting November 1st, November 9th, November 16th, and then the 29th.
Yep.
Okay? If anyone has a question, actually, I'm going to write that down right now so that Pat will get that straight.
The 19th, the 26th, the 1st.
The 1st, the 9th, the 16th, and the 29th. So we have four meetings in November. It's just not the week of Thanksgiving.
Yep.
Thank you guys for,
sure.
I appreciate
happy
you
to
understanding
it.
That.
So we do have, we'll begin interviewing next week to narrow down the field of applicants to put forward to the
So you are interviewing next week.
Yes,
thank God.
Next week, and the actually, I think all next week, and then let me think about this. Yeah, it should be all next week. Should have, and then we'll put it forth
to the, this board to look it over, and then, and it, we assume would have public, that's something for us to discuss, but probably do public interviews. So invite people from town to come.
Yeah, I was just going to say we should have an audience.
Yeah.
That, I mean, open it to the audience to ask questions.
I'm thinking it would be very similar to the, superintendent. You know, we had several people picked out some, and then the whole board interviewed in public, so for the last.
That sounds really good. Thank you.
Yep. So we're working to do it as fast as we can.
And the only thing I forgot to have Pat send a letter to the assessors last week, and so it's too late, is just, you know, sort of have the John Cordero give us an idea of what they want to do on the overlay.
Oh, right.
You know, they, under the new Modernization Act, they don't have to certify every 3 years. It's every 5 years. What do they want us to do? As of November 7th, all the money from all the years is squished down into one line item. So
they could push them back if they don't need it, or hang on to what they need to.
Yeah, and the Verizon poll thing, remember, I don't know. I haven't touched base with John to find out where we are on that. And so I'd rather have him make a suggestion and work with them. So
okay.
Let's have Pat send a for their meeting.
Sounds good.
Can I speak to something on the public comment thing?
Sure.
I've received a few letters from residents in opposition to the senior condo project that's proposed on Sugarloaf Street.
Okay.
And, you know, and this one individual wanted the Board of Selectmen to have a public hearing to discuss this matter. And I'm not opposed to that, but I think that there's plenty of public meetings that anyone is more than welcome to attend, the planning board meetings. There's going to be several more to deal with this. And, you know, we invite anybody to come and listen and participate in this meeting. But this one person said that she was concerned that after the preliminary planning board meeting that she went away with this was a done deal and it was just going forward. And I just wanted to assure everybody that that's not the case, that, you know, we have a lot of bylaws in town, and that any individual who tries to bring a proposal forward has to meet a lot of criteria. And so the preliminary process that they went through, we also hired a peer review person from the Franklin County Chamber. No, it wasn't a Chamber of Commerce, the Council of Governments.
Yes.
And they reviewed the plans as well, and everything was satisfactory going forward. But by no means is this a done deal. There's a lot more plans that need to go before the planning board. There's stormwater bylaws.
All the definitive stuff.
There's a lot of definitive stuff. There's a lot more. So anyone that has any concerns, you know, please attend the planning board meetings and express your concerns there. That's the appropriate venue. And by no means is this a done deal, you know.
Public comment.
Right. There's going to be public comments. But, you know, people have to realize that anybody, if they follow the rules, they are allowed to do these things. And if anyone is, you know, doesn't particularly like the rules, they should become more involved and come to our town meetings, not just special ones, but annual town meetings. So when these rules come before the town, that we get a good view from everybody in town, not just a handful of people that come. Mm-hmm. And I sit through a lot of town meetings, and I do think most of them are quite boring, but that's where you have to put in your time. You mm-hmm. can't just sit at home, and then when something comes up that you don't like, say, oh my God, what are you doing? Because as a community, we make these rules, and we have to live by them. So become more involved is the best thing that I can suggest.
I guess I just want to reiterate, too, is that the select board really doesn't have any jurisdiction into the process.
Correct.
Other than, like, sewer hookups. Mm-hmm. But as Board of Health, we have already indicated we are concerned. It's in our minutes. And we are concerned about standing water.
And retention ponds.
And retention ponds. And, you know, we are concerned about the drainage. And so that has been forwarded to the planning board. And the most important thing is that they do participate in the planning board process. And I just would like to reiterate what Kip has said, you know, I was on the planning board for many, multiple years, and the definitive process has not started. You have a preliminary process, and you have, once the preliminary plan is filed, you have up to 7 months to file a definitive plan. And in that period of time, the idea, although this was a pretty complete, or I mean, there's a lot of detail in this preliminary plan, there's no means a definitive plan. And the definitive plan will be submitted, and then this peer review will happen that will check all the calculations and answer the stormwater concerns. And so it will be multiple meetings. The preliminary plan is just to give you the idea of what's happening.
The other thing in which people had a lot of concern about was safety and traffic. And I believe, this is more of a question, I think, is there a traffic study that will be done in the definitive plan part, or is that something? Because I know that the DOT had to decide on cutting in the curb cuts and the distances
well,
and
DOT
all.
Well, the DOT yeah, so gives the curb cut. And so
they might have to do a study to find out the safety of this whole
thing. If there's
a
question.
If there's any requirements from the Department of Transportation, the applicant would have to comply. But there is a certain, I guess, jurisdiction that the planning board has with traffic, too. And, it's not going to be as detailed as what the state would do. But
right.
It's not just the planning board, because the planning board hires a professional planner
correct.
To review this as well.
Right.
So it's not just the opinions of the planning board members. We do rely on our professionals to do it. So, you know, you have the applicant who hires a professional to do this for him. He's not just winging it.
Correct.
And then you have the planning board who then looks it over, but then we send it off to yet another professional who reviews it, and then we all come together as a group. So those are important meetings for
the
neighbors or general public to get involved with and listen. If they have questions, they can address, you know, the people at that time.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thanks. Great. Thanks for bringing that up.
Yeah.
Because, yes, there has been a lot of activity. Okay. Public comment? Jeff, do you have any public comment?
No, I was just wondering if you have an idea of when the warrants and articles will be ready for release to the public.
Well, next week. We're
next
shooting
week,
for
Wednesday,
next week.
Hopefully.
Week.
Yeah,
we're hoping next week.
Okay.
We're trying as hard. I mean, it's my fault. If it's not getting done, it's my fault because I'm doing
it. No, I know it's difficult. You're shorthanded, it's understandable. I was just curious if there was a projected date that you're hopefully going to be able to release to the public.
If we're going to have the 14th as a special meeting,
correct.
Special town meeting date, we have to do it next week.
Yeah. Okay.
Because we need the 2 weeks to post.
Right, to get those out.
We have Veterans Day in there, so that's why we have to do it next Wednesday.
Yeah. Okay.
But and that we're going to try. It's just going back and forth with more, you know, the articles, and then every time you turn around, there's more articles. And, I mean, we just keep adding in.
And the last thing that I have, is there any update as far as finalizing, the deal with the bakery?
We're
as far
hoping
as terms or anything.
Well, Kip, do you know any more about the water line?
No, that's the bottom line. We've had some discussion with the people from the bakery and the water lines, and it's kind of up to them which way they're going to go. You know, at least my position is strong to get them to connect Merrigan Way to Sugarloaf Street, and then the town won't have to get involved with this. Forever agreement, maintenance agreement. And I think that they're leaning that way, but that's something they're working with their engineer on.
They had, as you remember last week, they had misinformation on the size of the pipe.
Right.
And they needed a sprinkler, so that's why they wanted to go the more complicated route. It's cleaner to come off Sugarloaf.
Right.
And so we're hoping that that's, and we're hoping to close next
Has
the
there
end of
been
the month.
A date set to finalize this?
No.
No. Okay.
Part of it is
I was just curious.
We're kind of ready, except for that.
We're still kind of planning to close at the end of this month.
Yeah, we're planning to do it next week, but...
So the terms can't be released until after the signing?
The what?
The terms of the agreement.
Oh, well, that's been pretty public. I mean, you know, the price hasn't changed.
Right. Has there been tax incentives enough for them?
Well, they haven't. I'm sure they're going to want to do a TIF at some point.
Yeah.
But we haven't met to do that yet.
Okay. That's why I was just curious. I don't mean to put you on the spot.
No. We wanted to close and get the property on the tax roll, and then we'll start. And they want to get going. So I'm sure we'll be approached for a TIF. And we, of course, we'd be interested.
While we're on that subject, though, was there anything in the agreement as to a timeline for them to construct that building?
They I think there is. I vaguely remember. It's been so long.
Like,
it's
I know, but I almost think it was like they had to.
They
get
have
it
to
going.
Do it in like in the spring.
Yeah,
right. Something. Could you make a note of that? It's one thing that I'd like Wendy to look into.
Well, you can just have the agreement.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. Dig it out. I don't know where it is.
Yeah.
I took that computer part nut and bolt, and I couldn't find that agreement there anyway.
Oh, really? Oh, I'm sorry.
Find the cheese inside.
Yeah. let me get put it down. Yeah. I mean, we've been talking about it for 2 years, so.
One thing I kind of wanted to bring up, too, was maybe, speaking of that computer, is that something that we could kind of have a personal file on, so the emails and stuff that come in, we can create a folder in there, just to, not personal as in personal stuff, but, like, you know, my phone is getting full of emails, and I know they come through the town, but if I know I have an email there, but is there...
We should be able to do this,
We should hook up something so that we could just forward all these emails, and I can keep a folder there to... keep all this stuff. I mean, because this gets heavy to carry around. I'm going to have to start a new one pretty soon.
No, it's however you want to.
Yeah,
however
we should
get
set up
a little
office space there for us all.
However you want to organize it.
Okay,
see,
I'll work with them about it.
I like hard copy, so.
And I don't mind a hard copy, but just I don't have all the emails are in my phone. Right. If this thing goes
but
in the
But the problem
the
with hard
pool.
Copies is that I have piles of stuff at home.
I know. I need a desk. I need a bookshelf. I've got so much
and
stuff.
And so I have boxes. It's like, this is what we're working on. This is what, So.
But if we could organize it. I just wasn't sure if that was okay for us
work.
To organize a little spot in there.
But your I don't know if you want to call it foresight or whatever, did come true because my dining room table is now as my wife does not appreciate it.
Right.
I know.
But, you know, that old adage, out of sight, out of mind, well, that's true for me. So I keep everything where I can see and keep an eye on it.
Yep.
And I know where everything is. But the problem is, like, Thanksgiving and Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I have to.
You need to make room.
I have to hoe out. And so
It's
however you want to do it. It's just, for me, there's so much material that I highlight it and when I read it. And
yes.
If it's on the computer, it's too much. So, anyway, I will take a motion to adjourn. If you're done, Jeff. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to cut
anybody
you off.
Thank you very much.
And thank you, Andy, for coming.
Yes, thank you so much.
We'll take a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
I'll second it.
All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.